Hello everyone, welcome to StudyIQ. Myself Dr. Ravi Agrari, and we are here to the target prelims exam 2019 session with July 2018 current affair issues for environment, ecology and biodiversity. So let us start here. This is the beginning. This is the second lecture of my video, and again I will inform you guys if you people have missed my first video. So first you see that video and later on you start this video. This is the lecture number 2 with July 2018 onwards. See guys, in this examination regarding the environment issues, I always say to you about the syllabus. So here I will tell you these all the units you should follow in your preparations. The first unit is the basics of ecology, its related concepts. Many chapters are here. The second topic you should consider about the climate change, various climatic chapters. These various chapters are here. The third one is the unit international conferences submit. This is the chapter which are here. Unit 4, that is different regulatory bodies, laws and acts in India. These are the various chapters you should follow here. The next one is the unit 5, that is the environmental impact assessment that you should read out, and the chapter here. Unit 6, population and solid waste management, and chapter is here. Okay, the next unit is the biomes, natural vegetation, floristic region of India. This is a common of environmental geography. Geography plus environment, both it cover. The next one is a unit 8, biodiversity, wildlife conservation, species recovery program, with various chapters and miscellaneous topics. So all these topics, again I repeat, these traditional sections means conceptual parts, and with contemporary issues means current affairs, both you should merge in your preparation. So traditional part I already covered in my discussion, in my classroom discussion, and contemporary issue portion even left there, and this time this is important, and here I'm going to start with the current affair issues of all related units. So let us start guys. Before going to start this lecture, I will tell you this PPT and all this PDF even upload on my Facebook page. You can go and download there, and apart of this you people can also follow me on my Instagram profile. So see guys, this is one of the question last time I discussed with you. It's a mistake guys. Actually UPSC prelims 2017 question number 9, you just do this correction. UPSC asked the question, if you want to see ghadiyal in their natural habitat, so which of the following is the best place of visit? Actually I was very fast in that video, so I could not be very sure, but here I'm very sure guys. Natural habitat asked, not about the conservation zone asked. Okay, in the last video I told you it's a Bhitarkanika. No guys, it's a conservation site of the ghadiyal is the Bhitarkanika, human made, but the Chambal is a natural habitat actually. So natural habitat, you will do this correction, it will be a Chambal river. So I apologize for this. The Bhitarkanika is, that is the conservation site for the ghadiyal. Okay, and see some information those you should know here. The ghadiyal is one of the longest living crocodiles in the world, found in the northern part of Indian subcontinents. Okay, and due to the loss of riverine habitat right now, the ghadiyals are mostly found naturally in the Chambal reserves, Chambal river, and the listed as a critically endangered. Bhitarkanika mangrove, that is in Odisha, it is only the conservation site for the ghadiyal in India. Okay, so don't be confused with this. That was just a silly mistake those I have done there, but as a teacher it's good to me, even for everyone guys, I should inform you that correction you should do. Okay, 2018 are shootout days fall in the August 1. That was the article related to you guys. Shootout is actually here, it's a date when the humanity annual demand in the nature exceeds the earth can regenerate over the entire year. Actually there is a lot of problem guys, those problem human generate on this earth and their own existence diversity, and this is going to be calculate with the help of Global Footprint Network and Worldwide Fund for Nature. So Global Footprint Network and the Worldwide Fund, even they are going to measure about the global shootout, how, what about the diversity of the earth is going to change suddenly. So this is the information here. Actually this time we people are totally dependent on the natural resources, a lot of natural resources, and this burden is going to increase day by day. So to increasing the burden on natural resources, we are actually, you know guys, this time those natural resources produce that 170% of the natural resources we are going to consume. 170% means if 100% natural resources is what overall that is required for the human being worldwide population wise, so we are going to exploit it 70% more. It means 70% more exploitation of the natural resources worldwide people are doing. That is the meaning of 170% of world's natural output. Currently it is a humankind. This, that is equal to, if earth is one diversity, so it's 170 means it is 1.7 earth size of diversity we are going to use right now. That is not good. And with time, guys, in 21st century, the diversity we are going to utilize, it's a two earth equal type of diversity we are going to utilize. It's a what? It's a exploitation of the earth and their own natural resources. So ultimately, the 70% extra resources we are going to use, it should be minimized. Actually, you know, guys, earth produce those resources, even can be utilized by the human being, guys. That is 100% resources which is being utilized. 70% extra resources we are going to use means which is not possible to naturally recycle. So 70% of exploitation, and this 70% will reach by 21st century as a two times. I hope you understood this line. It's a very interesting line, and here it's a good question can be occur in your paper. What is the reason behind it, guys? The main contributing factor to the humanity's ecological footprints are carbon emissions. So those carbon emissions are going to be happen, guys. You should measure it. That about the impacts, all measurement, which is called as a ecological footprint. So how it is going to calculate it? Okay, the shootout, the earth overshoot, okay, day is calculated by dividing the world biocapacity by world ecological footprint in 365 days. So overall, guys, total biocapacity, okay, you just measure in the comparison with the world ecological footprint in all 365 days, and then those value will come. This will be overall the earth overshoot. Okay, what is the earth is going to exploit right now on the basis of natural resources? Now the question is biosafety is what? Biosafety is the estimation of its production of a certain biological materials such as natural resources. So you should know what is the biocapacity. It is the estimation of production of certain biological materials such as the natural resources. That is the total biocapacity. It is going to be divided by world ecological footprint in 365 days. Overall, you will get as a overshoot. Overall, the earth overshoot. Okay, and that even the day even celebrated, it was the 1st August. Okay, and now global footprint network is what? Global footprint network is here, guys, those even used for the measurement of overshoot. Okay, the earth overshoot. This is an international non-profit organization. Those was founded in 2003 to check about the environmental sustainability. So about the sustainable future of the where the people have an opportunity to utilize the planets. Okay, means of the planet, within the planets. And what is the function of the global footprint network, guys? It develops and promote tools for advancing the sustainability. And overall, it will measure the various amount of resources on the planet, guys, means on the earth. Fine. What is the suffer? Suffer is the very important question, guys. And suffer is what? It's a system of air quality and weather forecasting. Is a full form of suffer. Even suffer is even brought by the Ministry of Earth Science. See, here I will show you my mobile phone, guys. In my mobile phone, I will like to show you the suffer applications and all the discussion. Those are mentioned here through the help of application. You people will understand very well. And even I will recommend to everyone, please, if you are listening me this video, my video, so better you go and install the suffer app. You will get a lot of information here. So here, this is the suffer app, guys, and I will show you the suffer app. You just see, this is a suffer app. I just to open it. Okay, and all the procedures you will get here, you just see, it is taking a time. See, this is a suffer app. I just to install, and now it's a file open. Okay, so I hope everybody can see this file very easily. Okay, this is a suffer app file. Fine. And see, have a lot of cities names are mentioned there on the top, guys. And the just on the top is mentioned as suffer India Air Quality Service. Okay, India Air Quality Service. And here some select cities names are Delhi, Pune, Mumbai and Ahmedabad. I hope you are doing this exercise with me this right now. And this lower portion is written there. It is powered by IITM. IITM means what it is written here. It is powered by Indian Institute of Tropical Meteorology, Pune. And it is being operationalized by Indian Meteorological Department, IMD. So this is, I hope you got it. And see, guys, if I go and select anything else here, okay, just like Delhi. Okay, if I select the Delhi and I just want to check about my home, that is in Noida. So you will get the something is going to change here, some of the values going to change here. And this is even measure the AQI values, air quality index. And here air quality index going to measure with the help of various kind of colors. And various type of colors and the various values are given there. On that basis, you can identify what about the pollution level in your surroundings. Okay, and see this one brought by the Ministry of Earth Science. This is Government of India. it's being responsible to make this all everything, air quality and weather forecasting. And now I'm going to discuss with you, but at last I will show you guys have a different colors even show there, and different colors have a different information. Those you can see on this camera, guys. Okay, on this camera. Okay, different informations are written there. Okay. So kindly install this software app, and now you listen me here, guys. Ministry of Earth Science, as I told you, as I show you in that software, in that app, suffer, and the first time it was used for the Chandni Chowk air pollution measurement in Delhi. It is a state of art air quality and weather forecast system. It is the first of its kind and most advanced system in India to check the air pollution level at every moment of time at your doorstep. Suffer is what it's a, it is developed indigenously by Indian Institute of Tropical Meteorology Pune, which is being operationalized by Indian Meteorological Department. See, it has been introduced for greater metropolitan cities of India, and at the real time basis it will inform you even not only the present time period, what about air pollution level, even forecast the next 1 to 3 days in advance. So in this app, if you want to check what is the possibility tomorrow, that will also inform you. The best one, if you do the exercise here, guys, through your mobile phone, so you will enjoy, and this concept will become very easy to you. See, it is an integral part of India's first air quality early monitoring early warning system, operational in Delhi. As you know, it was in Chandni Chowk the first time used. And see, not only the air pollution level, the gaseous concentration pollutant monitoring will do, even a part of these various parameters, environmental parameters, we also check, like temperature, rainfall, humidity, wind speed and wind direction. And later on, this one inform you the proper toxicity at your surrounding in air. What about the pollutants? Those we people monitor here, the PM particulate matter 1, the PM 2.5, PM 10, ozone, carbon monoxide, NOxes here, nitrogen oxide, nitrogen dioxide, sulfur dioxide, black carbon, methane, non-methane hydrocarbon, volatile organic compounds, benzene and mercury. So these are the various pollutants those we people measure here, monitor here. And see, not only this, I told you meteorological parameters we also monitor here, like UV radiation we check in your areas, rainfall in your areas, temperature in your areas, humidity in your areas, the wind speed in your areas, wind direction in your areas, even solar radiation in your areas. So all these measurements we do there. What about the significance of this system? I hope you can understand. For the awareness of a people, accordingly you will save yourself, accordingly you will save your kids, accordingly you will save your grandparents. Okay, air quality index is a tool, the most effective tools to communicate about the air quality status of the people, guys. It transforms the complex air quality data of various pollutants into a single number, nomenclature and colors, and I've shown you the nomenclature and colors, poor, very poor, satisfactory, whatever. There are 6 AQI categories in the different colors you have seen there, guys, and that AQI categories was good, satisfactory, moderately polluted, poor, very poor and severe. Okay, and these all define into the various colors. Okay, and the various colors have a different type of informations. Okay, each of these categories decided based on the ambient concentration of the air, which how it will affect to the human health, that information you will get on this app. Even AQI sub-index health breakpoints evolve 8 pollutants, which even they measure at the breakpoints. Okay, at every instant period of time, PM10, PM2.5, nitrogen oxide, sulfur dioxide, carbon monoxide, ozone, ammonia and lead. Okay, in the short term, National Ambient Air Quality Index standard, those are prescribed. Here 8 pollutants check. Neither overall in the earlier you have seen total 12. See guys, one thing, this was the question in the prelims examination, I hope 2006. If you listen my first video, 2006, 2007, 2008, you will get this question was there. Only the carbon dioxide and methane was the wrong answer. Neither I hope carbon monoxide was there. Sulfur dioxide was there, nitrogen oxide was there, that was right, except carbon dioxide and methane. This information you can get from ambient air quality index values. So Ganga Vriksharopan Abhiyan, the next one is the Ganga Vriksharopan Abhiyan. Ganga Vriksharopan Abhiyan is a, what it's a national mission for the those national mission for the clean Ganga, even broad guys. This national mission for the clean Ganga even organized Ganga Vriksharopan Abhiyan in 5 main Ganga basin states, and you know very well the Ganga basin states are what? Uttarakhand, UP, Bihar, Jharkhand and West Bengal. Definitely it will be there only. See, state forest departments, of these five states acted as a nodal agencies to execute this campaign. Okay, and see, about Ganga Viksharopan Abhiyan is what? It is initiated as a part of forest intervention in Ganga component of Namami Ganga program. And see, here we are doing the, here we are going to give a importance of afforestation. It is a part of campaign, even a school level, colleges level, at different departments and requested to adopt a plant. Okay, at least you people adopt a plant. Okay, and later on you will, this is the kind of a people's movement, and everybody will adopt a plant, and that plant safety and security they will do, and finally it is a kind of initiative under this campaign. Now the question is, what about the forest intervention in Ganga? Those even the campaign was initiated by this. Okay, foreign intervention on the Ganga. What is this? Actually, it is a significant in the aims to bring greater awareness among people and other stakeholders regarding the information of afforestation. Okay, if afforestation will be there, guys, so a lot of Ganga water we can conserve there. Okay, the lot of pollutant and everything will not be in the Ganga water, and proper cycle, proper the weather cycle and everything will maintain there. Okay, so this is the reason Ganga Viksharopan Abhiyan brought. Now, Green Mahanadi Mission. Green Mahanadi, it's a Odisha government based mission that launched. So Odisha government launched the Green Mahanadi Mission. Definitely this river is in that area. A total 2 crore saplings, the small size of the plants, will be planted on the bank of Mahanadi River. And see, this Green Mahanadi Mission, so sapling is what? It's a small size of the plants in the river bank areas, those will introduce, that is called as a sapling. Don't be confused with the sapling. And here it is the rejuvenating Mahanadi River and its tributaries, that is Tell and Ebb. So there are many tributaries of Mahanadi River, but here we are going to do the rejuvenating of these areas of tributaries of Mahanadi, Tell and Ebb, by increasing the recharging capacity of the river through massive plantation. Okay, see, under this mission, a total green belt will develop with a width of 1 kilometer that will be created on both sides of the river, and this river enter in the Odisha to Paradip, where it merges with the Bay of Bengal. You know, the total plantation will be undertaken around 75,760 hectares in government areas, and besides 47,470 hectare areas in the private land. See, what about the Mahanadi River? As it is a geography question, this time is very important. Mahanadi is one of the largest Indian peninsula river that drain their water into Bay of Bengal. It's a 857 kilometer long river, originated at the Raipur and direct of the central state of the MP, and flows to the eastern state of Odisha before meeting to the Bay of Bengal. Mahanadi River is a river of eastern India. Overall, it's a major tributary of Mahanadis are Sionath, Jong, Hasdo, Man, Ev, Pong and Tel. And Ev and Tel are those areas where we are going to spread and making a proper zone, proper Mahanadi conservation zone. Okay, that is here called as a Green Mahanadi Mission. Now the next one is the arsenic contamination was in the news in the July month. Arsenic, you know, it's a heavy metal. It's very, very toxic, guys. A few years back, there was a news about Dadri. The many people are suffering with the cancer, guys, due to consumption of the arsenic in the drinking water. Even the government advised nobody take a drinking water from this area. Okay. A recently publication by researchers at the School of the Environmental Studies, Jadavpur University, given information about the risk of arsenic in the paddy plants, and these paddy plants access the arsenic that arsenic came from the groundwater in West Bengal. Okay, so it's a information, and later on, guys, it is the information, guys, that is the arsenic accumulation that even identify in this area, and the study has been performed by School of Environmental Science Studies, Jadavpur University. Okay, what is the highlight of this, guys? Actually, the rice from contaminated is rice even contaminated from the irrigation water. As I told you, the uptake of arsenic is faster in the young roots in the vegetative state. Okay, in comparison to the older tissues of the plant. So in the beginning, when the plants are growing, in that time, the arsenic intake from the water is very high into the plant body. And see, two commonly consumed rice varieties under the study, guys, that was a Minikit, and the next one is a Jaya. That two, Minikit and Jaya was the studies here by this university students and professors, guys. And the study has raised a concern about the disposal of contaminated rice straw, which is used by the animal fodder, are burned or sometime left in the field. So these all activities are not allowed, neither it will come into the exposure of living organisms. Okay, next one is the article, next one is the question from Pet Coke. Pet coke was also in the news, guys. Pet coke is what? It's also not good, actually. Petroleum Ministry has told to the Supreme Court to ban on the import of petroleum coke. Okay. What is the background of it? I'm not going there, guys. But here I will tell you one thing, guys. Pet coke means petroleum coke is the bottom of the barrel left over from refinery of the petroleum products. So when you do the petroleum refineries, when you go send the petrol from the petroleum products in the petroleum refineries, at the end of this, the leftover portion after refining those left is a kind of pet coke. Okay, and the pet coke is what? It's create a lot of warming carbon and even more problematic. So what is the reason pet coke even we can also burn as a source of heat or energy? Even a more, it is a warming, produce a warming carbon and even more heart and the lung damaging sulfur even also generate there when this pet coke burn those generate after refining process of petroleum products. Even see, guys, you know, in some of the states many industrial units are working, like Rajasthan, like UP, like Haryana, and here have a increasing the level of pollution, and this is the reason the Petroleum Ministry has told Supreme Court to ban on the import of petroleum coke those utilized in these many states. Okay, even industrial units like National Thermal Power Limited and Hindalco even refused to give any relief for industrial units. It had also refused to give any relief to industrial units like National Thermal Power Corporation and Hindalco. So this is the reason, guys, they even going to utilize. So Petroleum Ministry directly has told to Supreme Court to ban on the import of petroleum coke those even utilize in NTPC and Hindalco. Okay, what is the concern here with the pet coke? You got it, the sulfur dioxide emission is very high. Okay, see, actually it contains 17 times more sulfur content, okay, than the normal coal, and staggering about 1380 times more than from the diesel. So this much of sulfur content we are even it is going to generate here. You know, that is the question in 2011 from thermal power plant, means burning of coal, which type of polluting gases emit in the atmosphere? CO2, SO2 and NOxes. Overall all gases were correct here, guys, but here I will tell you, here with the when you burn the pet coke is 17 times more sulfur than the limit set for the coal. What is the need for regulation? I just told you, guys, sulfur dioxide emission is very high when the pet coke burn, nitrogen dioxide is very high, and even the concentrated in the areas where the power plants and steel factories are clustered, in that area have a lot of concentration about the sulfur dioxide and nitrogen dioxide gases. Reason in that area, the pet coke highly used. Okay, pet coke create a lot of problem to the outdoor air pollutions. Even US Environment Protection Agency Industries, which is a non-profit funded, okay, they always concern about the health issues due to the problem of pet coke. So, and that type of bad situation also going to generate in India. Around, that is the data, guys, 1.1 million Indians die prematurely as a result of outdoor air pollution every year. Okay, and this is the data given by US Environmental Protection Agency and Industry. Now, 4 species added to recovery program by Wildlife Board. I will tell you, it is the most important question for this year. Okay, so what about these 4 species, those added in this recovery program? See, guys, National Board for Wildlife, NBWL. So National Board for Wildlife recently added 4 species into the Center's recovery program for critically endangered species, which are very, very, very less in numbers and near to extinct. These species are those NBWL even included, that are the Northern River Terrapin, Clouded Leopard, Arabian Sea Humpback Whale and Red Panda. So these 4 species even added and added by National Board for Wildlife. Okay, what are the terrapins actually? Terrapins has been exploited actually because of illegal trade across the borders, and especially for its meats, medicine and pelts, which are in high demands. Even the terrapins, Northern River Terrapin, is largely found in the West Bengal. Okay, if you go, the second one is a clouded leopard. Clouded leopard is dominating in the Meghalaya, Mizoram, Sikkim and Assam, while the red panda is largely found in Sikkim, western Arunachal Pradesh, North Bengal and part of Meghalaya. Arabian Sea humpback whale, if you see, guys, facing a threat from the accidental entanglement because of fishing gears, maybe ship strikes to the whale, guys. Even seismic explorations even also are the reason behind it. And see, humpback whale migrate migrate toward the India's west coast from Oman. So Oman to India's west coast, it is going to migrate due to favorable condition. Okay, so that is the humbug whale conditions, and now humbug whale is also considered under a species recovery program. So what is the species recovery program? So species recovery program in India started in 2008-2009, and here that species recovery program brought with the IDWH. It is mean from providing a support. IDWH is working especially to provide the support in this protected areas. Which type of protected areas IDWH support, guys? IDWH support the national park, wildlife sanctuaries, conservation reserves and community reserves except tiger reserves. Okay, even protected areas like wildlife, outside protected areas and recovery program for saving critically endangered species and habitat. So one information you always remember, those species recovery program under IDWH is going to perform, it is specially for critically endangered species and its habitat. See, IDWH was actually earlier with the name of Assistance for the Development of National Park and Sanctuaries, and that name even changed under 11th five-year plan by MOEF. Okay, by MOEF, Ministry of Environment and Forest, and then it become as a IDWH. You know what is the IDWH? Wait, guys. Yeah, what is the full form of IDWH? IDWH is what? That is the integrated, okay, that is the integrated development of wildlife habitats. So integrated development of wildlife habitat, it provides the support for under the species recovery program. Do you know, guys, earlier total 17 species were mentioned there, but in July 2018 four more added. So right now under species recovery program for especially critically endangered species, now we are going to conserve 21 species and four recently, you know very well. So see, some what was the earlier these 17 species recovery program by IDWH, those perform there, guys, those work under National Board Filed Wildlife, those added all these, guys, these names are mentioned here, you just listen, guys, these 4 and 17 are the good question. Snow leopard in these 17, bustard, dolphin, hangul, nilgiri, tahar, marine turtles, dugongs, edible nest swiftlet, Asian wild buffalo, Nicobar megapode, Manipur blue antlered deer, vultures, Malabar civet, Indian rhinoceros, Asiatic lion, Sam deer and Jordan crozier. Okay, so these 17 are there. Even India is the party of International Whaling Commission, and that is the reason is India even also work a lot for the protection of whale and its habitat in Indian waters. What actually the National Board for Wildlife, those included 4 more species under species recovery program. It is the statutory body constituted in September 2003 under Wildlife Protection Act 1972. And who chair the NBW? It is a good question. So National Board of Wildlife is chaired by Honorable Prime Minister. Okay, so now we go into the Nilgiri Tahar was in the news. It's a latest studies was actually the climate change is the main threatening reason behind the Nilgiri Tahar. Nilgiri Tahar, that is what, it's a endangered category. If you go in the IUCN have a 9 categories, guys. In these 9 categories, the endangered category, here the Nilgiri Tahar come. Even it is under the Indian Wildlife Act 1972 in Schedule 1. And I discussed with you in the Schedule 1 earlier, guys, it's a hunting and harvesting is totally prohibited here. Actually, only the hunting and harvesting is allowed under the certain laws. Okay, neither it's a crime here, guys, and have a good punishment. Okay, see, in Nilgiri Hill areas and southern portion of the western Ghat state like Tamil Nadu and Kerala in South India, okay, this Nilgiri Tahar is endemic, only localized worldwide in this area of the world. Okay, it is a state animal of Tamil Nadu, guys, and currently the only population with more than 300 individuals are in Aravikulam National Park and in Grass Hill in Annamalai. So these national park and grass hill in Annamalai may be a good question in your paper, so you should know. Odisha police launch a drive to burst pangolin smuggling racket. Yes, guys, pangolin have a lot of demand, and here I will tell you, India have a two type of types of a pangolin in the India, guys. Pangolin is actually, it is in endangered categories, okay, and one of the world's most illegally traded mammals, those you should know. Here Odisha police even going to develop, even have make a special unit to launch and try to save the pangolin. Okay, here a process has been initiated to crack the international pangolin smuggling racket with the help of mutual legal assistance treaty. So mutual legal assistance treaty even working especially at international level for the protection of pangolin against its smuggling. Okay, MLAT is what? MLAT is an agreement between the nations to exchange information or provide a legal assistance for enforcing a law. So this is the reason here the smuggling racket will stop and MLAT will work and try to protect the pangolin even in India. In what, why the pangolin have a black marketing, illegal marketing? It is smuggled because of its scales, and scales have a lot of medicinal properties. And see guys, the China is the main illicit hub for smuggling this pangolin. Scales have a lot of demand in their own medicinal and magical purposes. See, what about the pangolin? Pangolin features, if you go there guys, the pangolin is only the scaly mammal on this planet. And see, if you go into the site categories, that is the Convention on the International Trade in Endangered Species, it is most illegally traded vertebrate within its class under sites. Okay, of the 8 species of pangolin worldwide, 2 are localized in India. The one is called Chinese pangolin and second is called Indian pangolin. Chinese pangolin, if you see, it is critically endangered in India, but Indian pangolin, if you see, it is the endangered under IUCN red list. And see guys, it is also protected, the pangolin is also protected and the wildlife protection in 1972 in schedule 1. Again I repeat, schedule 1 base information are most important. Those species come under schedule 1. Now we go the next, that is called naturalized species. What is the naturalized species, guy? Naturalized species are intentionally or unintentionally introduced in a species. Okay, even they adopt to that areas, even they reproduce successfully, even they properly stable in that new environment. Okay, that is the naturalized species. But naturalized species is what? Even they reproduce naturally in the environment where they colonize. But see, recent news is what? The naturalized species are what? Naturalized species are those which is an introduced species from the particular areas, and now it is being there and being naturally involved in the reproduction without any restriction, without any disturbances. This type of species or organisms are called as naturalized species. But see guys, what happened? Even there is some problem, those even recently has been identified. And here have a news guys, around in the international team, including the scientists from some Indian scientists even work there, even under the various areas in India guys. And they found that around many as 471 plant species that are alien one, exotic, not native to India, are naturalized. Means they set up in India and they proper reproduce in India. They proper involve in the reproduction. Okay, the 471 plant species that are alien, one exotic, not native to India right now. Alien means what? Those came from the foreign countries. Okay, and they finally being set up here. And now what is they thrive in the country's wildernessness for forming stable population. Okay, so they develop their own stable population. What about the here some circumstances and some problem I will discuss there. First you see and go some factual data. Scientists have developed the first list of naturalized plants for each state, and the list reveal 110 alien plant now naturally occur in more than 31 state of India. So total 110 alien plants, those are naturalized in India right now. Okay, 110 alien plant now naturally occur, so they're being naturalized. Even 332 Tamil Nadu is the highest number of naturalized exotics. Later on the Kerala 290. Okay, and later on have a Lakshadweep was at least 17 total. Okay, see guys, a majority of these naturalized plants are mostly herbs in nature, and one of the invasive weeds that is the studies even those scientists have checked, that is Chromolina odorata. It is a native to South and Central America. The new list even show that many of the exotic species now part of our natural flora. Okay, even India is a hot spot of the naturalized plant species. Many of the plants even enter worldwide. See, here have a data around 13,000 plant species are naturalized in the ecosystem worldwide. Okay, many of these later turn invasive and impact the local flora and fauna. So in the beginning guys not, but later on it is being studied ki many of these later turn Not in the beginning, when they set up, they reproduce, they create a lot of problem to the local flora and fauna. So this type of studies even happen there in the respect of India. So watch out a naturalized plant, it may be a good question for your paper. A study identify India as one of the hotspot of the naturalized plant species. It means a lot of numbers of the naturalized plant species are identified in India. And see, in among seven regions in the world that the highest number of invasive species identify in India. And see guys, ENVIS data, what is the ENVIS? Environmental Information System Center on Floral Diversity has hosted a BSI Botanical Survey of India list, and around 170 invasive plant species in India has been reported. Now the government needs to strengthen the quarantine measures adopted before a plant is brought to the country. You know guys, actually for the NBPGR is the main leading center in India. You should know about the NBPGR, National Bureau of Plant Genetic Resources. If any plants are coming from any country guys, so it should go in the proper quarantine. The quarantine is first it will go check and then it will introduce in India. Okay, and this procedure should be proper in the proper discipline and the proper information should be checked. See, if some of the contaminated plant, some of the disturbing plants even come to India guys, and finally when it will grow as an alien species, it will come to India and they will disturb our natural varieties, native varieties. That is the information na? Here many of these later turn invasive and impact to the local flora and fauna. So this is the reason the good quarantine is very important, neither it create the adverse impact to the environment and human life. See the next one, that is the International Tiger Day, those we celebrate on 29 July. International Tiger Day is, it is in the news, so you should know the Global Tiger Day, that is also called as the International Tiger Day. It's an annual celebration, especially it is a kind of awareness. Those, through the help of this International Tiger Day, we raise for to work under, especially for the tiger conservation. And we celebrated it annually on the 29 July. See, a St. Peter's Tiger Summit that was created in 2010. There is some historical background I'm going to start. It's a global day. Okay, the St. Peter's Tiger Summit held in 2010. Here at the summit, that was a decision to take as a, to celebrate the International Tiger Day, guys. The goal of the day is to promote a global system for protecting the natural habitats of tigers and raise the public awareness. You don't think so only we are going to conserve the tiger here. Even those habitat area where tiger present, we also conserve that habitat areas, and finally in that way total tiger will conserve. Okay, what is the conservation effort? The conserve effort of the independent activities. Okay, various independent activities the person perform, various government policies even happen, various amendments in the Wildlife Protection Act, and raising different type of awareness. These all push a number of wild cats 2226 in 2014. That is the data guys. When the tiger census was held, then the tiger number increased 2226 even reached there in 2014 because of these type of conservation efforts. Okay, what about the concern and challenges about the tiger losses? So there is a reason depletion of forest in the responsible for reduction of the tiger habitats, reduce the food basis. Definitely guys, the forest land areas and development projects if introduced, habitat lands for the animal will lose. Poaching is the reason because at illegal market for the tiger body parts. Climate change like you know, the Bengal tigers habitats are only last remaining in what, in the Sundarban, and we are going to disturb the Sundarban because of the climate change. So finally what is there guys, these are the various problem those happen there. What about the conservation effort? That is a very very important, and you should know guys, National Tiger Conservation Authority has launched AMP Stripes, that is monitoring system for tiger intensive protection and ecological status. When you, if you people have listened my first lecture video of environment series, you know very well in 2017, I hope that was a prelims question, and I discussed the AMP Stripes there. 17 or 16 it was a prelims question. Okay, again I repeat, what is the AMP Stripe? Monitoring system for tigers intensive protection and ecological status. It is a mobile monitoring system, I told you, for the forest guards. So every moment of time, even it is a kind of, I will tell you, tiger sensor, that is a geographical information system, a remote sensing GPS based data even used to access the number of tiger for their own safety purposes. See, St. Peter's Work Tiger Summit held in 2010, leaders of 13 tiger range countries resolved to do more work for the conservation of tigers, and the effort is what here, to double its number in the wild, with the popular slogan T into 2. So T cross 2, T is the multiplication by 2. So this number in the 13 tiger range countries the worldwide, and here we'll try to increase the number doubles 2 times. Okay, so this one is very, very important. You remember, guys, the St. Peter Tiger Summit 2010. See, Global Tiger Initiative Program of World Bank also brought, especially to boost up the tiger numbers under the tiger agenda. Actually, Global Tiger Initiative Council even set up there, guys, especially with two arms, and these arms are mentioned there. The one is a Global Tiger Forum, and second is a Global Snow Leopard Ecosystem Protection Program. And through this, government try to protect tigers in India. Some controversial projects, even they also disturb the number of tigers in India. Those data I just to mention here, the one, highways and the railway lines are being expanded, and the information you can connect with the Kanha and the Pench Tiger Reserve, that is a main controversial project. Second one, the railway line is being constructed in through Melghat Tiger Reserve, that is the second problem in the tiger conservation in India. The third one is Ken Betwa River Living Linking Project. The submerged around 100 square kilometer area of Panna Tiger Reserve in MP again have a disturbances of tiger. So these are some reasons, and actually that even disturb the tiger population, and we should try to take a proper solution here and try to save the number of tigers, and here to multiply the two numbers in the coming future we will maintain. So thank you everybody, this is the video. Okay, here if for any kind of information and you have a problem, so kindly write down the information into the comment box. So thank you to someone, guys, those even inform me at least the question that I discussed with you guys, it was a misinterpretation from my side. The reason I could not read the proper question there regarding the gharial. So, but if anywhere have a doubts, so you talk to me and you discuss with me, you mention in the comment box. And see, sometime even shared in earlier videos, I explained with you, Rio Plus 20 was in Paris. No, guys, I not discuss, but when I listened the videos, so I got it. The one time I said that is a Rio Plus 20 due to miss words I use in this discussion, that was in Paris. But later on in the same, when I discuss in the next line, I said no, it is actually in the Rio de Janeiro, Rio Plus 20. Okay, so maybe it is possible, guys, in my brain has something, but in my words there is something more skipping there. So if this type of mistake happens, so kindly inform me. But yeah, gharial was a mistake and I have done this correction. So thank you everybody for your kind information. Give me updates regularly. Don't forget to listen these books, and this is available in the gyanword.com and amazon.com. okay, you go and read out, all the chapters are given there accordingly with all UPSC question paper you are able to solve there. Okay, thank you everybody, take care, all the best, bye. Hello everyone, welcome to StudyIQ.